Tesla is always seen aiming for big things. Be it an innovative ambition, idea, or more tangible items, Tesla would rather go big. Perhaps it is due to many successes that the company has racked up in a very short time of its existence. Or it's just the CEO Elon Musk's never-ending quest for technology advancement. In either case, Tesla tends to come along and fundamentally change how things are done, just like with its new Gigapress. What is Gigapress? And how does it work? How is it a game changer in the automaking business? In today's video, I will be talking about Tesla's Gigapress. However, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe to Technology Fit and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you never miss any updates. So without further ado, let's get into this. Gigapress are giant die casting machines made by the IDRA group based out in Italy. It was actually named by IDRA and not Tesla. Its purpose is die casting large parts in a single unit piece. If you have a head for figures, Gigapress produces a clamping force of between 55,000 kilonewtons and 61,000 kilonewtons. Gigapress is the biggest casting machine that has ever existed. To give you an idea of how massive these machines are, let me mention for you some facts and figures. It weighs about 410 to 430 tons. That's the equivalent of 5 space shuttles. Its size is similar to the size of a house at 20 meters by 7.5 meters by 6 meters and requires dozens of flatbed trucks for transportation. And to give you an idea of what a Gigapress does, think of a small plastic toy car. You would notice that the framework is made from a single piece. That is exactly what Tesla Gigapress tries to achieve. Instead of a framework that uses up to 70 bolted and welded parts, as it does by all other car makers, the new Tesla framework will be one solid piece of engineering feat. Are you wondering about how does it work? Well, in other words, how does die casting work? The principle behind it is very simple. You force the molten matter into the mold and let it cool down. Then you remove the mold and reuse it. Gigapress just does that on a larger scale. To make the frameworks of Tesla's cars, the Gigapress has to be prepared first. The aluminum is melted into an external oven that can get as hot as 850 degrees Celsius. The aluminum, however, contains 8.5% silicon, so technically it's an alloy. Then a robot sprays soybean oil into the mold to help the finished framework come off the mold cleanly. This is followed by a measured amount of molten aluminum being injected into the casting chamber of the Gigapress at a scalding 750 degrees Celsius, and then forced into a mold by a high-speed plunger. The next step is to open the mold, which is still very hot at 400 degrees Celsius. A robot arm will then pick it up and place it on a quenching tank to lower the temperature to 50 degrees Celsius. Measuring, checking for imperfection, and trimming follows to remove rough edges and excess materials. The framework then continues its merry way down the production line where more robots are waiting to work on it. Speed is key to this process. You would be pardoned if you think that this process takes hours for a single chassis. It actually takes seconds. A production cycle can take place in less than 90 seconds, and the Gigapress is ready for the next framework production. As compared to bolting and welding parts together, as done by other car makers, Tesla has brought a rocket to a bike race. Tesla owns and operates 2 Gigapresses at the Fremont plant, 3 in Shanghai, and 1 at each different stage of completion in Berlin and Austin. But it is told that the vendor supplying the Gigapress will be kept busy, as Tesla has placed an order for up to 10 more units. Its plant in Berlin might end up with 8 units, while the Austin factory may eventually have 3 of these giants. This was the first benefit of using Gigapress. The Gigapresses require a lot of space and investment. So, why do you think Tesla is going to all that trouble? It could rather choose to stay at the paths of older car manufacturers by welding and bolting things. To start with it, Tesla can simply make more cars. It is easy to follow the math done by JP Morgan when they investigated their monster machines with an assumed cycle of 4 to 5 minutes. 1 Gigapress can output 70,000 to 90,000 units in a year. Using the Model Y as an example, 2 gigapresses are needed to make the front and end body parts. A plant with 10 gigapresses can produce 350,000 units of the Model Y annually. While this is an impressive number, the gigapress in Fremont has been observed to take less than 200 seconds to complete a run, even with optimization efforts still ongoing. As per specifications by IDRA, a gigapress can complete a cycle in 90 seconds, which means that about 1,000 castings per day can be done. At any rate, gigapresses will help Tesla make a lot more cars than they are making now. This in turn means that Tesla is poised to meet its goal of a 50% year-on-year increase in production capacity. For the upcoming year, Tesla wants to ship 750,000 units. Its stable of gigapresses will be the core step to achieving that aim in subsequent years. Well, keep in mind that Tesla is a visionary company that doesn't shy away from taking on challenges. JP Morgan followed up on the casting machines and concluded that it was revolutionary for the auto industry for several reasons. Another advantage of the gigapress is that they make cars cheaper. This reduction in costs comes from several sources. First is the framework being made itself, which becomes 40% cheaper to produce with the use of gigapress. Secondly, as massive as these monsters are, they result in about a 30% reduction in the size of the body shop. It isn't surprising, as car manufacturing happens at big scales. So, less facility construction and maintenance for Tesla helps a lot. Thirdly, there are savings in labor costs as robots do more of the work with production. Tesla could slice off a significant 20% of its labor-related overhead with these giant machines. Tesla is already fantastic about cutting costs. It believes that this is what will make the elusive $25,000 electric car a reality. Well, the gigapress may just be what humanity needs to achieve the wanted price point for cars. This can actually help Elon Musk achieve his goal to electrify the global transport industry quite efficiently by creating cheaper electric cars. With gigapresses, Tesla will be able to do this job quite better. Using the single casting, defects like bad alignments from coupling over 70 pieces or components are avoided, making Tesla vehicles of high quality. With gigapress, Tesla is definitely heading towards a revolutionary change in the car production industry, which is something more companies will try to and should follow in the future. It will, by all means, benefit the makers in production as well as buyers with affordability. Don't forget to share your thoughts and valuable feedback with us in the comment section below. That's all for today's video, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked the video, make sure you share it with your friends and give this video a thumbs up. And if you have not already subscribed to our channel, subscribe to it and press that notification bell so you receive a notification each time we upload an interesting video on this channel. Thanks for watching this video. We will see you in the next video. Take care and stay tuned.